Allison Sterling reporting for Strayer Times. I'm in the small Scottish town of Dreadmon, where people are fleeing in massive numbers. Locals say mysterious illness has caused rapid aging. The town is full of abandoned vehicles and suitcases. It's unbelievable.
As we both know, Master Detective, unbelievable has become your calling card. We can only rely on you to get to the bottom of such a perplexing mystery.
Again, coming to my rescue, just like back in Dire Grove. What was it, nearly a decade ago? You are officially my guardian angel, Detective, though I'd bet this isn't a chance encounter. If you're here to investigate what's going on, maybe I can pay you back with information. Follow me. A friend of mine from high school, Maggie Sharp, lives somewhere in Newlywed Square. I just need to find her address. You're way ahead of me, Detective. But maybe I should go first. I'm a familiar face.
Henry, is it... Oh, I'm sorry. I'm not interested in buying any wares. I feel quite out of sorts today.
I'd recognize those eyes anywhere. That's definitely Maggie Sharp. Only 60 years older than she should be. Get us in there, Detective. Sorry to barge in, Maggie, but the Master Detective and I are here to help. It's me, Allison Sterling. Do you remember? From school?
No, I... When was that?
You really don't remember? You were a transfer student in the States for 2 years. We even took a graduation photo together.
Thank you.
yes. We sat next to each other. Alison, I'm terribly sorry. My mind is in shambles. Dreadmond is changing too fast.
We noticed. I'll try to make this right, Maggie. Just tell us what you remember.
Well, I woke up in the middle of the night. Something was pressing against my chest, and the veil of mist started to smother my thoughts. I think I reached for the phone. Yes, and I called someone I thought could help us. But I can't remember who.
Richard Galloway. Our mailbox is currently full and cannot accept messages. I apologize for the inconvenience.
Huh? Richard Galloway? I've heard of him. He's like the town benefactor. How could he help with this situation? You should go talk to him in person. I'll stay here with Maggie. Maybe she'll remember something else.
Thank you.
whoever you are. I'm already doing everything I can to solve this crisis. Though, I suppose, if the Royal Agency sent the famed Master Detective, I could do without the burden. Hey, stop right there! I've unlocked the gate, Detective, but be warned, there's an intruder in my...
The troublemaker slipped through my fingers. I'll be with you momentarily, Detective. I just need to make sure my valuables are all accounted for.
Thank you.
Already snooping around, are we? Ah, don't be embarrassed. I admire your dedication to sleuthing. Please, join me. Records of abnormal magnetic field below Dreadmon have been traced back to the time of the Druids, but its activity never spiked in modern times before yesterday. I'm confident this is the cause of our city's troubles, but I think I'm close to a solution. I've created a device that can help with the phenomenon. It's installed by the statue in Newlywed Square. Unfortunately, the key to the device was stolen by little Henry Sharp. We need to get it back for the sake of the town. Here, once you retrieve the key, unlock the device and activate it. And hurry! Time is one thing we don't have.
Did you talk to Richard? Henry just paid him a visit too, though not in a way that would make a mother proud. I apologize. He can be such a willful boy when he gets an idea in his head. Now, Henry, the detective is here to help us. Give us Mr. Galloway's trinket. There, detective. I do hope you'll be able to resolve this quickly. And even though Henry can't speak, I know he's truly sorry for the trouble he caused.
slimy, no good Richard Galloway is responsible for everything. But you look exactly the same, Detective. How is that possible? The quill must have protected you. Well, don't worry. I'm not going to just roll over and die. I'm still going to help. Here, look at this. I'll follow that lead while you deal with the situation in town.
Thank you.
You have opened the gates of the Abyss. Death is an old acquaintance of yours, Detective. That makes us kindred spirits. But you still have much to prove.
Test subject, Maggie Sharp. The training was successful. The prototype signal is weak without enhancement. The statues are a perfect conduit.
Sight. Above a lake of stars, a world littered with scars. Oh, there is a landscape won, adoration of your prodigal son.
Thank you. not going any further.
Master Detective. Trigger-happy cat. I advise you to go outside. I have something to demonstrate.
Good work, William. Now, open the gate for the master detective. Behold, detective! Celestial beauty worthy of any price.
House.
soon as the detective arrives, you must hinder the investigation. Follow my instructions to the letter, and your family will be set for life.
I'll do whatever it takes, sir.
Up there? I fell through the floor. Detective, I was on a verge of breakthrough, but the power went out. This will help you get control of the factory. Catch! Oh no, it's a good thing there are spares. Catch this one. Phew, I didn't want to worry you, but that was the last one. Now get down here. I think I'm onto something. We need to get the generator working again if we want to see anything. To be honest, the room looked better in the dark. I found the research of a local journalist that investigated Richard's past. I was hoping to find answers, so I followed the lead here. The man was paranoid for a good reason. This is a hideout where he conducted his research before he went missing. This must be a clue. Did Richard hide something in the library? I'm going with you. These are the drawers from the photograph. Redmond is doomed unless you turn off all of the conduits.
may find ourselves in a peculiar situation, Detective. I'm sure you'd love to arrest me, but as long as I have Allison... Under the circumstances, listen to some fatherly advice and proceed left to Dreadman Lake. I want you to save Allison. I need you to be the legend I've heard so much about so I can witness you in action. What I've done might seem cruel, but it is necessary. I am the keyhole. You are the key. Together, we'll unlock the unimaginable. When you reach the end, everything will make sense. Now, listen, and I'll tell you a story. History teaches us that great epiphanies usually start with small things. An apple falling from a tree, the refraction of light, mold on a piece of bread. However, mine started with fire, screams, and barbed wire on the battlefield. I was there in the summer of 1960, declared by the Somme. As the bullet went through my chest, she emerged to carry me to the Valley of Shadows, the Dark Companion, the Goddess of Death. I look good for being 100 years old, don't I? Well, you haven't heard anything yet. As fate would have it, I cheated death that day. Ever since, the Quill has protected me. I raided the Parisian catacombs, the dungeons of Prague, and the mountains of Serbia in search of a key to her astral home. In the Balkans, they call her Morana. In Scandinavia, they call her Hel. In Brittany, they call her Anku. Through my travels, I have amassed great knowledge. This is where you come into play. You are the instrument I need. You will open the gates of the Dark Realm. I never found the key, but I learned how to build one. Each of the statues that is activated is a turn of the lock. Each drained soul is a sacrifice required to lift the veil, to tear through it and reunite me with Anku. Master Detective, if I am to be Jack Ketch in this infernal analogy, my axe requires the finest honing. Wouldn't you agree? I'm known to be quite courteous to Dreadman visitors, even though they end up tied to a chair. But you deserve special treatment. Therefore, be a good Pinocchio and get the present I've left on the chair. Geppetto's got to run now.
Detective, he told me this was a gift for you. Henry, stop! It's too dangerous!
Child at the same time.
The water is freezing. Detective, save Henry! you're Henry's guardian angel now, too. He wanted to give you something from his backpack. I'm too weak to move. It's too late to escape. Just do one thing for me. Stop Richard.
Thank you.
I will rid this world of its mortal coil and embrace on the edge of eternity. All thanks to you. Rejoice! Soon, your judge will arrive, and your soul will be cleansed of rage that has consumed you. File. Gerald Sykes, a noble factory worker haunted by his wife's adultery. One day, amongst his wife's jewelry, he found a heart-shaped necklace he hadn't given her. Upon closer investigation, he discovered love letters between his wife and a close colleague. Thank you.
He waited until the end of his shift to confront him, distraught. He made a critical mistake when handling molten metal. His colleague wasn't the only casualty of the resulting fire. His rage took 30 lives in one clean swoop. Is an endless procession of souls. One must judge with a clear conscience. What is your verdict, detective? No! You throw him into the fiery pits? Where is that legendary forgiveness I've heard about? Can you feel that? Forgiveness is like a balm of enlightenment that caresses the souls of the redeemed and those there to witness. In the fires of the trials I've set upon you. And the key is in the lock. The weight of the soul sacrificed to Anku's quill determines the length of her reign on Earth. You confronted malevolence and saved innumerable lives. Your soul is as heavy as the world itself. And all about you, your rank, your education, your name. That is why I chose you. Dreadmond was a pilgrimage to virtue. And you were deemed worthy. The key and the legend. Grateful brat, I have guided you, groomed you, given you purpose. And this is how you repay me.
you only knew what a curse it is when death comes for everyone but you.
I want to be like you when I grow up.